Wildcats chase rats, China. Once a Chinese emperor organized a race for animals. The first 12 animals to finish were to be given a place in the Chinese zodiac. The cat and the rat, both lazy creatures, asked the ox to wake them on the day of the race. The day arrived. The ox tried to wake them up, but could not succeed. The race was about to start. The ox coaxed them onto his back and started running. The rat woke up when the ox was crossing the last hurdle, a river. The rat pushed the cat off the ox's back. When the ox reached the other side, the rat jumped off and scampered to victory, just ahead of the ox. The tiger came third, crossing the river by using the backs of the animals swimming across a stepping stones. So, the 12-year cycle of the Chinese zodiac begins with the rat. After him come the ox, tiger, rabbit, dragon, snake, horse, goat, monkey, rooster, dog, and pig. The cat, however, has no place in the zodiac. So all the cats still remember the humiliation heaped on their ancestor by a tricky rat and thus chase the rats to punish them. The Fisherman Who Rose Too High, Europe. Once there was an old fisherman. He would go fishing in the morning and return back in the evening. One day while fishing, he saw a large heavenly bird Kaha sitting on a rock. The bird said, "You need not do such work. From now onwards, I will bring you a big fish every evening." She began to drop a large fish at his doorstep every evening. The fisherman would take it to the market and sell it. He soon became rich. One day he heard that the king wanted to catch Kaha bird and would reward the informer with lots of gold. The fisherman was tempted. He told the king that he could get the bird. In the evening, when the bird brought the fish, the fisherman asked her to come inside his house, as he had laid out a feast for her. The moment she came to the ground, the fisherman grabbed her legs. But Kaha began flying with all strength. She rose into the air, the fisherman still clinging onto her legs. The fisherman realized that he was too high in the air to let go. Neither he nor Kaha was ever seen again. Advice, Italy. Once there was a great battle amongst animals. After the war had ended, a porcupine and a fox were returning back together from the battlefield to their respective dwelling places. The fox had an evil thought of killing the porcupine, but the fox was worried about the coat of sharp spines on the porcupine's body that would not only protect the porcupine but also injure the fox. However, the fox was very clever. The fox thought for a while and devised a trick. Pointing at the coat of spines, the cunning fox asked the porcupine why he was wearing that armor of spines. The porcupine told that it protected him against the deadly wars of cunning creatures. The fox flattered the porcupine by saying that the war was over and harmony established in the forest, so he should remove the heavy armor and feel relaxed. The innocent porcupine was unfortunately convinced by the fox's advice and took off his armor. The fox promptly pounced on him and killed him in no time. Therefore, it is said to beware of advice from those who have their own interest at heart. Totally Useful Youth, Malaysia. Once there was a kind youth. He was always keen on helping others. One day, he was strolling near a lonely hut. He saw an old man in front of the hut. The youth thought that the old man must be some learned sage. He asked the old man, "Sir, I want to be good to all. How can I do that?" The old man went inside his hut. He came out with an elegant casket which was latched. He handed it over to the youth and said, "Take this casket home carefully and open it. Then you will know what to do. But remember not to open it on the way." The youth thanked the old man and carried the casket away. But on the way he wondered what could be there inside. He could not suppress his curiosity. He opened it, completely forgotten about the warning of the old man. As soon as the casket was opened, the youth was transformed into a strange tall plant. He became a coconut tree with leaves and nuts at an unreachable height. Today, we all are very well familiar with this most useful tree.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.